Hey, stargazers. Constellations are a group of stars in the sky, and the stars form a shape or an object assigned by humans. Since prehistoric times, humans have been using the stars to help navigate and find their way across the Earth. The first evidence that shows constellations were being used in this way is from 17,000-year-old cave art. Many different ancient cultural groups have defined constellations in their own way throughout time. However, modern constellations, they come from ancient Greek sources. The 88 constellations in our sky were formally established by the International Astronomical Union 100 years ago. Standard constellations, they're like a shared language. It makes astronomical observations and identification so much easier. For example, the supermassive black hole in the middle of our galaxy, it's called Sagittarius A star, which means when you look in the sky, you can find its position by looking in the boundaries of the constellation Sagittarius. Overall, while constellations aren't as useful for night sky navigation as they were in ancient times, they're still an important part of astronomy. Not to mention, knowing which are which is a great party trick. If you're interested in seeing different constellations in the night sky, there are a couple of tips to factor in. First, the constellations you see at night depend on the time of the year, because Earth is in a different spot in its orbit throughout the year, so the stars are going to move slightly west every night. Also, where you are on the planet matters too. Since the Earth is tilted a bit, those who are in the northern hemisphere are going to get a slightly different view of the stars than those who live in the southern hemisphere. In the northern sky, many people use the North Star to orient themselves, known as Polaris. You can find it using the Big Dipper, but fun fact, the Big Dipper, not actually a constellation, it's an asterism. Asterisms are also patterns of stars, but they're usually smaller than constellations and take up parts of them. They aren't recognized as one of the 88 constellations. The Big Dipper is actually part of the constellation Ursa Major, the Great Bear. After orienting yourself under the night sky, you can find your favorite constellations and you can really get stargazing. If you want more tips and tricks on what to look for when stargazing, check out our weekly Stargazers videos. And as always, keep looking up. For more Stargazers, click the video below. Don't leave me hanging. Come on. Click it.